Hello, welcome to this new host of our video. My name's Alex. Today we're going to be looking at the UISP switch, which is actually in stock at the moment, which is a pretty rare thing. We released a blog post in July just going over the setup process of the new UISP switch. We got it adopted to the UISP controller, had a look at all the features and how many ports it has and the app setup process because there's no web GUI for the UISP switch. In this video, we're going to be looking at the hardware itself in a little short video. And then we're looking at the setup process in a video form, as well as all the different features that UISP has. The UISP switch and the UISP router both support transport connector. It's a new anti-removal power connector for those two hardware devices. So it means that things can't get accidentally unplugged. There's like a locking mechanism for the connector. The other end of the power supply, there is a IEC cable, which isn't anti-locking, which is a bit strange. And once we do that, we'll now dive into the hardware overview. On the front of the UISP switch, we've got 8 gigabit RJ45 ports, all with 27 volts PoE. And then the right-hand side, we've got the 1 gigabit SFP port. On the rear, we have a ground connector, as well as the 27 volts input for the power for the switch. With the power supply, we've got the new transport connector, which features a locking mechanism for sort of prevent anti-removal. And then you can see I'm pulling the connector there just to display it actually doesn't come out. Looking at the back of the switch, we can see that the power connector plugs into that 27 volts input, and that connects up to the power transport power supply. You can see here my switch is ready to be adopted into your ISP, the white light indicating it's ready to be adopted, and I've got an uplink connection in port 8. So I've now got the UISP mobile app set up, just to adopt the UISP switch into UISP. We saw there briefly on the screen that there was a pop-up showing you that the UISP switch was detected. That was using the Bluetooth from my phone to the switch. It's exactly the same setup for the UISP router as well. So here I'd pick a name. It gives you an overview of the ports. You can go in and specify if there's any power needed. And then do the finishing up process. After this, it will ask you what site you wish to connect the switch to. I'm just going to skip towards that section now. Okay, that took about a minute or two. I now pick a site I wish to adopt the UISP switch into. So this is my Hostify site. And now it's in the UISP. That only took about 2 or 3 minutes. So I'll just give you a quick overview of the app screen. You've got reboot options. You can reset the device to factory defaults. You can change the management IP range, management VLAN, static IP, that sort of thing. It's also got an overview of the ports. Notice that you can't change the PoE type on the input port. You can also specify the voltage, so 4-pair 27 volts or 27 volts. So I'm back on my desktop PC now. I can see that the UISP switch is adopted into my Hostify UISP controller. There's no local GUI, so this is the only way you're going to be able to change anything on the UISP switch. Very similar to the mobile app, along with a few more options. So I've got all the ports here, which are all capable of doing PoE. List of the ports, I can go in and specify the PoE voltage. So I could specify 27 volts if I wanted to on there. We've got settings, we've got NTP servers, system log, which you can output to a remote syslog server. You can enable or disable the web UI, even though there's nothing on there that's going to be of any use. You can turn on SSH, you can make the switch discoverable and all that sort of good stuff. And then you can open up a terminal from the device to UISP, and you can log in remotely. You can locate the device, make it flash, take backups, change the firmware, which are on the latest available version. That's pretty much it. There are some other options to do with VLANs if you go to the old device detail. So I think Ubiquiti are working on adopting this into the newer screen. But the same sort of services, but you can now change the VLANs as well. So you can make new VLANs, very similar to Edge switches, this user interface. It's also a Mac table and statistic graphs as well for latency, that sort of thing. Okay, if you've got any questions, don't hesitate to let us know at support@hostify.com. One of the team will be happy to get back to you. All the links relevant to this video will be linked in the description below, along to the blog post for this actual video as well. Thank you for watching. This has been Alex from Hostify.